What an incredible privilege to get up close to these animals. You can't imagine how large they are. That it, words just cannot describe. And you know, everyone on that vessel when we first came up close to a blue whale let out a gasp.
Overall, the mission has been tremendously successful, exceeded all of my expectations. I think the most exciting achievement is just our, you know, having the ability now to find these blue whales in the really thin soup that is blue whales in the Southern Ocean right now. There used to be 200,000 blue whales in these waters, and now there's something like 1% of that, might be 2%, but it's really hard, given the vast areas here, to find them. And we now have this acoustic technology that allows us to do it with unprecedented speed and accuracy.
My daily job involves deploying solenoids, managing a team of passive acoustics experts who are listening for whale sounds and guiding the ship to the whales, working with the ship's crew and the visual observers to make sure that we have every chance possible to see the whales.
Yes, we've detected blue whale calls.
So this is the first voyage of its kind. This is our success rate has been very high. We've demonstrated that these techniques of listening for whales and heading towards them can enable us to sample and get to very rare Antarctic blue whales.
Photo identification of blue whales involves taking photographs that allow us to recognize blue whales as individuals, similar to taking a photograph of a human. With photo ID data, you can estimate population abundance, you can delineate stock structure between different population stocks of blue whales, you can also track movements on fine and large scales, such as migration routes. These photographs that we're collecting on this voyage will be contributed to a larger Southern Hemisphere-wide blue whale catalog.
I guess one of the key things with this is to make sure that you're working within the parameters of your permitting, and also that you have a really good understanding of behaviour and be able to read whether or not you're having a negative impact on the animals. The Antarctic voyage has thrown out a lot of challenges to someone like myself, being my first time down to this region. Not only the climate and the conditions that you're faced with, but also these animals, which I've never worked with before. They're extremely fast, they're quite large, as everyone would know. And for what it's worth, I prefer to work with them closer to the ice edge, where they seem to be more relaxed.
We have a very experienced coxswain who drives around the whales and has learnt whale behaviour for the last 10 or so years. And so he generally predicts what the whales are doing, and when he sees a moment to get close to the whales, he will pick that moment to bring the boat in fairly quickly. Often the water is very rough, so I'm bouncing about in the bowsprit, trying to focus on a whale and where I need to deploy my tag. We'd like the tag to have the most opportunity to communicate with the Argos satellite system. So the tag needs to be forward on the body and quite high on the body, so it's out of the water as much as possible for the surfacings of the whale makes. Well, once I placed a tag on the blue whale, I was actually in a state of disbelief and shock. I didn't react at all. It was slow motion, and I turned around and looked at my colleagues, and I needed their confirmation that I'd actually tagged an Antarctic blue whale. And once that had happened, I was grinning from ear to ear. Since we placed a tag in the whale, it's managed to travel north incredibly quickly and then travel west. So it's travelled over 1,000 kilometres since we tagged it. We have very little knowledge of the movements of Antarctic blue whales, and in particular, we're very interested in the linkages between breeding and feeding grounds.
Well, it's amazing what we can do with these samples. We can learn so much about these animals and in a fairly non-intrusive way. So from each skin sample we collect from a blue whale, we then extract DNA from that sample. And through that DNA we can obtain genetic signatures for each individual. And then we can track that individual. Has that individual been sampled previously on this voyage? So we can look at movement within a season. And we can also match those genetic signatures to individuals that have been sampled on previous voyages between seasons on a broad scale.
I couldn't imagine a better bunch of scientists or crew to work with. They're all dedicated, hardworking, getting up every morning at 5 a.m., putting on your heavy clothes, going out into the sometime driving snow, and looking for whales. It's not an easy task.